So I'm here in Google Sheets right now, and I have my budget printed out. So I'm going to do some things to format it correctly. Just typed in the numbers, and I'll format them in a second. So firstly, give it a clear file name, course name, name of the assignment, and you know, your full name always looks good there. So for financial statements, we want to center the heading at the top, and it usually goes name of the business, name of the statement, and date in that order in the first three rows. So we'll go format, merge cells, merge horizontally, format, merge horizontally, and then again we'll merge it the first five cells across, and then I'll center that, so that'll be nice and centered. You know, for the indentation, we don't want it to be too much, you know, maybe just a couple of spaces. I'll drag this over, and we'll make this one a bit bigger so that it will, you know, everything will fit. I'm going to select the cells that have the numbers in them, and I'm going to change the formatting to accounting or financial. You know, that way it'll be a bit more precise. We'll have this the cents, two digits for the cents, and we'll, negative numbers will be in brackets. So I'm going to use some formulas here. So equal sign opens the formula, sum, open brackets, and then I'll add up all my sources of income for my gross income. Then, you know, to get my disposable income, I'll subtract the income from the deductions. Now the deductions are already a negative number here, so that's why I use the add sign. If you know, you didn't make it negative beforehand, you'd want to do a subtraction here, but your disposable income is always going to be less than your gross income. And you know, to sort of indicate that it's a sum, I'm going to take the border, and I'm going to do a border underneath. Likewise, I'll add up all the necessities that we purchased using the sum function, and I'll just drag my cursor to select C14 to C17, and our discretionary income is going to be the disposable income minus our necessities. And again, I'll just put, you know, a little line here to indicate that it's a total. I'm going to, you know, take our variable expenses, things we don't have to purchase every month, you know, total those up as well, and then any leftover amount will be our discretionary income minus our variable expenses. And again, just to indicate that it's a total, I'm just going to put a little bit of a line here. And also, you know, to be clear, I'm going to label this sheet. I'm going to call it personal budget, so the viewer knows that this is where the budget is found. Okay, so the next step is to sort of break down our sources of income. So I'm going to select the number, and I'm going to select the label. I'm going to insert a chart. You know, you can make a number of different charts. You could do a bar chart if you wanted, a donut chart. I'm going to choose the pie chart, and I'm going to give it a clear title. So, you know, sources of income, and you could, you know, raise the font size if you wanted, you know, change the color, click on any of these fields, you know, to change the font to a color, whatever you want to customize, you know, make it as you like it. And then, you know, once it's here, what I'll do is I'll click on the three dots, and I'll move it to its own sheet. I'm going to double click on chart one and name it sources of income, and that way everyone will know that that's where the sources of income, you know, can be found. If I wanted to save it as an image later on, you know, to embed it, I could, you know, save image, and it would save it as a PNG file. Okay, so the next thing I want to do is I want to add up all my expenses. So I'm going to select anything, necessities and variable expenses, and insert a chart. Make it the same type of chart. You know, I'm going to select a pie chart, and you know, you can see all the blank fields, they just weren't included in the pie chart. And again, you know, I'm going to select, you know, expenses October 2018. And I'm going to make it its own sheet so that it's nice and big. Move to its own sheet. Expenses. And again, if you want to do any customization, you know, go ahead and do that. So this will be one of the files that you submit that has all three tabs in it and kind of will be the figures that you talk about in the second part.